The solar system has many more moons than the one we can see in the sky. But how many do we know about? And how many more are waiting to be discovered? If you look up on a clear night, the brightest and largest object in the sky will probably be the moon. It is the only natural satellite you can see with your own eyes. As a result, most people have a wrong perception of what a moon is and how common these natural satellites are. In reality, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of natural satellites in our cosmic neighborhood, ranging from irregular town-sized space rocks to massive rounded bodies that are potentially big enough to be considered planets in their own right. So exactly how many solar system moons have we found? The answer depends on your definition of a moon. The International Astronomical Union officially recognizes 288 planetary moons orbiting the solar system's 8 worlds, according to NASA. But there are also a further 473 small body satellites, the moons of asteroids and dwarf planets, listed by NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. If we count both types, as most astronomers would, this brings the total number of natural solar system satellites to 761 as of June 2024. But this is likely just the tip of the iceberg. Edward Ashton, an astronomer at the Academia Sinica Institute of Astronomy and Astrophysics in Taiwan. Astronomers have found dozens of new planetary moons and small body satellites in the last few years alone. And technological advancements will likely accelerate the rate at which they can spot more in the coming years, he added. According to Ashton, the simplest definition of a moon would be an object that is in an orbit around a larger, non-stellar object. But that is not quite the complete answer. For example, there are currently thousands of human-made satellites in orbit around Earth that satisfy the definition above but are not considered moons because they are not natural. These spacecraft also have limited lifespans before falling back to Earth and burning up in our atmosphere. Some natural satellites, such as quasi-moons and mini-moons, are also temporary and do not truly orbit planets. Starting closest to the Sun, our home star's nearest neighbors, Mercury and Venus, have no true moons because of their proximity to the giant ball of gas, which would have ripped away any potential moons from the planets long ago. Venus does have one known quasi-moon, Zuswe, but this does not count because it orbits the Sun, not Venus. Moving on, we come to Earth. Our home planet has just one major moon. However, it also has at least 7 quasi-moons and occasionally gains additional mini-moons for around a year at a time, but these don't count as moons. Next up is Mars, which has 2 true moons, Phobos and Deimos. Both are just a few miles wide and orbit very close to the red planet. Phobos is slowly falling toward Mars and is predicted to crash into the world's surface someday. Moving on to the giant planets, things get exciting. Jupiter, the first gas giant, has 95 moons. 4 major ones are Callisto, Europa, Io, and Ganymede, the largest moon in the solar system. Saturn has even more moons, at least 146. Some of its major moons include Titan, Mimas, and Enceladus. The ice giants Uranus and Neptune have 28 and 16 moons, respectively, and 7 major moons between them. But these numbers have changed significantly in the past few years. There are more than 700 known natural satellites in the solar system. However, as we have seen, this number is likely to grow significantly in the future. Past studies have shown that there could be hundreds, if not thousands, of tiny planetary moons that could be discovered with more powerful telescopes. And as we have already seen, there is great uncertainty about how many small-body satellites are really out there. But this uncertainty doesn't stop researchers from being able to venture a guess. They guess that there are probably about 10,000 moons in the solar system.